water, earth, fire, air. Long ago, the four nations lived together in harmony. Then everything changed when the Fire Nation attacked. Only the Avatar, master of all four elements, could stop them. But when the world needed him most, he vanished. 100 years passed and Sokka and Katara discovered the new Avatar, an airbender named Aang. And although his airbending skills are great, he has a lot to learn before he is ready to save anyone. But Katara believes Aang can save the world. The original Avatar: The Last Airbender animated series holds a special place in my heart. It is arguably my favorite series of all time, the only animated series I hold legendary status. The animated series which I fell in love with was a journey that transported me to an entirely different world filled with elements of our own world. Philosophies, satires, good comedy, and wonderful teachings. It was a show that had everything. However, the recent Netflix adaptation of the series into live action has left me questioning its necessity. The live action series, despite extending the length of the episodes, still falls short of the original's charm. The series also do a Batman v Superman Dawn of Justice thing where multiple episodes or stories are combined into a single episode. However, it is visually awesome. There were several moments that gave me goosebumps. The live-action adaptation, while respectful of the source material and clearly a product of hard work and dedication, fails to improve upon the original. It spends too much time explaining rather than showing, which takes away from the mystery and discovery that made the original series so enjoyable. The characters often sit down and talk about who they are, what they want to do, why they want to do it, and their connection to other people, which feels unnecessary and wasteful. The live-action series also tones down the humor, a crucial element of the original series' identity. The humor in the live-action series is mediocre at best, with half of the jokes being okay and the other half falling flat. The series also lacks the vibrant and unique world that the original series created, making it feel less impressive and more like any other generic fantasy. The performances in the live-action series are a mixed bag. While some actors like Paul Sun Hyung Lee, who plays Iroh, deliver great performances, others seem to lack passion. The acting often oscillates between caring about what they're talking about and looking lost in what they're talking about. Katara, in particular, was extremely underwhelming as she lacked the emotional connection and motherly wisdom that made me form a bond with her in the animated series. The matriarch of the Southern Water Tribe and Sokka and Katara's paternal grandmother only exist in this series or season to say exposition and nothing else. The live-action adaptation of Avatar: The Last Airbender is not a bad show, but it's not a good show either. It fails to justify its existence and does not improve upon the original. Die-hard fans of the original series might find some enjoyment in seeing live-action versions of the characters they love, but they are likely to be disappointed. For those who have never seen the original series, the live-action adaptation might be an okay introduction, but it certainly won't leave a lasting impression. I can see why the original creators walked away at some point. That's my opinion on the live-action adaptation of the Avatar: The Last Airbender. Do you think it's a fantastic representation of what Avatar was? Do you feel it's even worse than the Last Airbender movie? Are you somewhere in between where it's kind of nice to see it in live action, but it's nothing great and nothing's going to beat the classic? Let me know in the comments below. Please do drop a like and subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you in the next video. Life out here, I scream and it goes silent.